Pretty Witty 77, and if you're a witty, then welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, whistle. Today I'm going to be giving you guys 5 tips on successfully transitioning your hair to natural. Now, a little bit about me, boo. I have done it all. I've had waist length, tailbone length, relaxed hair. I've had really long, thick Tex-Lex hair, and I just decided to transition to natural. I didn't have a problem with my other hair. I just really wanted change. And the fact that I actually transitioned for 2 years and 5 months, trust me, if anybody gonna give you advice on transitioning, it's gonna be me, because my transitioning was definitely long term. My first tip will actually make or break your transition. You have to be gentle with your hair. If you are transitioning to natural from whatever previous state your hair is in, you're most definitely gonna be working with 2 textures. I, for a little bit of my transition, worked with 3 for a while, and honey, that's patience, okay? And if anybody got patience, trust me, it's been me. But this is gonna actually make or break you, because you do have that line of demarcation where your relaxed hair or Tex-Lex hair meets your natural strands. That part is really, really fragile. So if you just yanking, if you feel like your hair is tangled and you just need to detangle it real bad, take a breath, apply conditioner, and take your time. Do not yank your hair out, because sometimes you're going to be forced to end your transition, because your hair is going to be so damaged. And hell, the relaxed hair or Tex-Lex hair are going to fall off by themselves. Them strands are going to be gone with the wind because you didn't take the time to be gentle. Now, one of my sisters is currently transitioning to natural, and one of the biggest problems that she runs into is washing it, how tangled it gets, and she just gets really frustrated. It really depends on what your hair texture is. For me, it worked best for me if my hair was wet with a whole bunch of conditioner throughout my hair, just saturated with conditioner, and I start from the bottom, detangling and working my way up the top. Now, my second tip will most definitely have to be to trim regularly. Yeah, I know you want to hang on to the little length that you have, whether you're transitioning from shoulder length hair, bra strap length, or waist length. I actually transitioned from very long waist length hair, and trust me, if anybody know the struggle, trust me, I'm the struggle queen. I done been there. I opted into the struggle, so no complaints. But it's no secret, you are working with 2 different textures. That relaxed hair or chemically processed hair at the end of your hair strands, they're gonna split. They're completely different texture. You're gonna have to trim them out. So I would recommend you trimming your hair every 3 to 4 months. It does not have to be a lot, but you most definitely need to be creating those new ends, because your ends are the oldest part of your hair. Like, you gotta let it go, sis. Hashtag let that hurt go. Now, the third tip is super important, period. Deep condition regularly. I cannot stress to you how important this is. I remember when I didn't deep condition my hair every week, and I would always put it off. Oh, I'm gonna do it on Sunday. Sunday get here. Oh, I'm gonna do it Wednesday. Then I'm like, I'm just gonna continue on Sunday. And it was just an ongoing thing until I had to put my foot down. I was like, you know what? I'm gonna deep condition, and I'm taking people with me. So I started a series to deep condition my hair, and I was like, okay, you're gonna be my accountability partner. Y'all gonna look for these deep conditions every Sunday, because somebody else out there needs to get on track too. So I created this series, and it most definitely have helped me so much to stay on schedule. If you need help, I got you, sis. But you do need to be deep conditioning your hair. It needs all the moisture it can get, especially your new growth, sis. Do not neglect it. Now, while we're talking about deep conditioning, let me just drop this 4th gem. Now, I know that it's hard not to try new products, but you do need to be consistent with the products that you're putting in your hair. Some products may not work for you, but if you find that product that's like okay, it's not like horrible, but it's not the best, I would recommend for your pockets and your time's sake, just stick with what works okay. If it's not doing your hair any good, by all means necessary, go look for something that does. Don't go searching for rainbows when you ain't even got the primary colors. The state of your hair is like still changing. Your hair might like a product when you are transitioning, and your hair might not like that product when you're natural. Trust me, it happened to me with my favorite deep conditioner. I used a deep conditioner about 4 or 5 years. Transition, I tried to use it on my natural hair, poop. So it's really no need for you to be, okay, let me try this deep conditioner. Let me see how this, if your new growth is okay with the stuff you're using, Don't try to, okay, well, let me go see if my chemically processed hair, if I can find something to make that feel good. No, stick to what you know. Let your hair recognize those products that you're putting on, and you basically know the results that you're going to get every time. And the fifth gem that I'm about to drop is definitely necessary. Find your go-to hairstyle. Now, my go-to hairstyle has always been the twist out. I had go-to products. Of course, these same products that I was using for my twist out do not make a popping twist out now that my hair is completely natural. So most definitely find the style that you're most comfortable with. I knew that even though I was working with two different textures, I could do flat twist outs and I could put perm rods on the end because, you know, my ends weren't curly at all, okay? That was limp as I don't know what. So I did this until I could not anymore. Towards the end of my transition, my twist outs, I don't care if I put rods on the end, they fell, the texture was just off. And sometimes you know in your heart that it's time, you know? And I didn't rush it. I didn't let anybody rush me. When it's time for you to chop, you're gonna know it in your heart. I was kind of fed up towards the end because I was having problems with my go-to hairstyles. Buns used to be my go-to hairstyle, and then my ends were really straggly. And when I would try to create that big bun look, like, I just couldn't get the look I desired. So I was really frustrated about that. And I chopped. Some people decide when to chop and some people just wake up and go get scissors and chop. For me, I knew towards the end, I was like, okay, I actually chopped 7/7/2018. So I knew that I was going to probably be cutting off the remainder of my process ends in July or August. It was July or I was going to do it on my birthday. But I was like, you know what? I don't know how my hair is. I've never worked with my hair completely natural as I have been chemically processed since I was like 5, 6, 7. I can't even remember. Way back when I wasn't even allowed to do my own hair, I was chemically processed. So no, I did not know that my curls would look like this. No, I did not know about like hair textures. I just knew when I seen new growth that I needed to relax. But yes, sis, definitely find your go-to hairstyle. Try some things out. A lot of girls like perm rod sets because that perm rod gonna create that curl all over and it looks more uniform. Buns, twist outs, those were basically my go-to. When I was in the gym heavy, I would do like a French braid on this side and a French braid on that side. And if somebody was like, hey girl, let's go somewhere. And then I would take the two braids out and it would create like a really big wavy braid out, but I never did do like really little braids for a braid out. Like, it just didn't look right. So yeah, those were my 5 tips for successfully transitioning to natural. If you guys enjoyed this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, sis, subscribe to my channel. What are you waiting on, sis? You finished the video. Definitely rock with the kid. You will not regret it. Oh, and on your way out, go ahead and hit the notification button. Bell so you can be notified every time I post a video. As always, thank y'all so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.